In this video, we're going to use integration to find the area bounded by y equals x plus 5, y equals 5 minus 3x, and y equals 0. So let's start by taking a look at this region. I'll start by graphing the line y equals x plus 5. And then we also have the line y equals 5 minus 3x. And then also the line y equals 0, which is just the x-axis. So the region bounded by these three lines is this region right in here. Now there are a few different ways we could approach taking or finding this area. So first let's consider integrating with respect to x, which is what we've done in the past. So if I wanted to do this, integrate with respect to x for this region, I would have to divide my integral into two pieces because the top function is different for different parts of the region. So let me show you what I mean on the graph. So if we wanted to integrate with respect to x, we would have to divide the region into these two pieces based on the fact that the top function changes. So that's definitely a valid approach. But let's think if there's another way we could do this where we wouldn't have to split up the integral into two pieces. So instead of integrating with respect to x like we've done in the past, we can actually integrate with respect to y. And when we integrate with respect to y, we're going to be thinking about right minus left. So if I look at my region again, the same function is always on the right, and the same function is always on the left. Sometimes it's helpful to think of drawing rectangles to represent my region here. So if I draw these horizontal rectangles, I can see that this function, y equals 5 minus 3x, is always on the right, and my function y equals x plus 5 is always on the left. So then let's try integrating this region or finding the area of this region by integrating with respect to y. Okay, so how's that going to work? Well, when we integrate with respect to y, our integral has pretty much the same form. We're still integrating over some interval c to d, but I'm going to think of this as right minus left dy. Now one key thing to note here is that the bounds of my integral should be y values and that my right and left functions should be in terms of y. So if you want to think f of y minus g of y. So that's basically what we're going to do here. So then what I need to do first of all is I need to rewrite my equations of my lines so that they're functions of y instead of functions of x. That's not too hard in this case because they're just lines. So if we take y equals x plus 5 and simply solve that for x, I get y minus 5 equals x. Okay, so then I can just think of this red line as x equals y minus 5. Okay, and then I can do the same thing with my other line. So my other line is y equals 5 minus 3x, and let's just solve that for x. So I can write this as 3x equals 5 minus y, or x equals 5 thirds minus 1 third y. So I can think of my blue line now as the function x equals 5 thirds minus 1 third y. Okay, so now I have everything in terms of y. I can start setting up my integral. Let's leave the bounds off for a minute. We'll think about those in a second. And let's go ahead and fill in our functions. So my right function, which is this blue line over here, I just figured out that that was 5 thirds minus 1 third y. minus my left function, which is my red line over here. And I just determined that that was the function y minus 5. And I'm integrating with respect to y. Okay, so notice here that everything in my integral is a y. Okay, that's really important. So then I want the bounds on my integrals to be y values. So I need to think about what y values this region spans. Okay, so I'm starting down here at y equals 0. That's the bottom bound of my region. Okay. And then the top is this point, y equals 5, where these lines meet. So my integral then is going to be from y equals 0 to y equals 5. So this integral, if I evaluate it, will give me the area of this region. So let's just take a minute and evaluate this integral. So I can start by just expanding a little bit inside my integral. And I can write that as 5/3 minus 1/3 y minus y plus 5. And then if I do a little bit of combining of terms, I should get the following. 20/3 minus 4/3 y and dy. And then I simply take the antiderivative. So that should give me 20/3 y minus 4/3 y squared over 2, and I'm evaluating from 0 to 5. So that's the same as 20/3 y minus, let's see, that should be 2/3 y squared from 0 to 5. And so I plug in. So if I plug in 5, looks like I should get 100/3 minus 50/3. And if I plug in 0, I'm just going to get 0. So it looks like my final answer here should be 50/3 for the area of this region. So if instead you wanted to find this area by breaking the region into two pieces and integrating with respect to x instead, you should get the same answer because it's the same region either way. So with whatever you integrate with respect to, you should get the same value for the area if you do it correctly. Now, in this case, you also could have done this geometrically with the area of a triangle, and you should have gotten the same answer in that case as well.